Ryan, thanks so much for joining me. Today we are talking about this palette by Hourglass. It's the limited edition 2019 palette. If you'd like to see that, please keep watching. So I had to pick this palette up because it is the fifth one that they've done, and I have collected them ever since the very first one. And I think the Hourglass products were one of the first videos I ever made. Hourglass has a very special place in my heart and on this channel because I love their products. So I had to pick this one up. Not because I was excited, because these are not new right here, but these are new and I've tried these before and they're not colors I typically use all the time. But I just thought, I've gotta get it. I was really interested in the other blush palette they offered, but I just bought a whole new palette of other blushes by a different brand. So I thought, that's too many. So I thought I would just get this and try them all on for you. So I've got all six colors on right now. We're just gonna go ahead and see what these look like on, and I'll talk about the details at the end. Let's go ahead with the palette. I've used these before, so I was like, I guess I'll just use them again because I don't really use dim light. But I did notice that I think it might be good for the center of my face to try it again. And then the diffused light right here, the lighter one, I'll go ahead and just kind of put that under my eye area and just right down the center of my nose and see how that goes. And then the strobe lighting powder. So let's start with those first. So those are not new. These are the new ones. Let's go ahead with the dim light. I did have the Hourglass brush that I purchased the last time. This is probably the best brush simply because these pans are so close together and they're not that large. So that's one good reason to get this brush. I mean, you can find other brushes that do the same job, but since I had it, I thought I'd use it. So I'm just going to use this to finish off the center here. As usual, I finished off with Charlotte Tilbury number 2 in medium, and I do just pat it because I have so much concealer and other things happening that I don't like to sweep that out of place too much. So I've been using this here. It just does kind of what that By Terry CC powder does for me in the apricot. It just lifts this part of my face, which can get a little bit kind of dull when I add so much concealing and color correcting. It also helps to mesh these two parts together, the part that I concealed versus didn't conceal. So it just does a nice blurring effect. I'm going to take this side, which is a little bit more tapered, and take this lighter shade in Diffused Light, this one right here. It's so interesting, the fact that it's a clear plastic makes these shades look different than how they look in other palettes. There's something I noted. I mean, these are good. They're nice staples to have. I don't normally pull for this. If I'm using, not if, when I use a finishing powder, it's always Radiant Light by Hourglass. I am testing out a few more, like I said, from other companies right now, but still nothing compares to these finishing powders. Okay, and then I'm going to wait on the highlighter just because I'll do that last. I'm going to go in with the bronzer next. This is the Eternal Bronze Light. And a bronze in this figure here, just along the jawline. It's very subtle on me, this shade. I usually pull for Radiant Bronze Light. Interesting, I don't know if you see, it's coming across a bit cool on me, almost as if it's a blush rather than a bronzer. It's pretty. I just prefer Radiant Bronze Light on my skin tone. And as always, I like to overdo it with bronzer. So this is a lot of bronzer for you. I get carried away with bronzer and blush. And I do like to do my bronzer before my blush. I feel like it helps create that structure first. Now let's go in with the blush. So we have two blushes here. I always like to use two if I have the opportunity. So what I'm going to do is I'm going to take this deeper shade first. I'm going to take that and I'm going to just add it right here. And then I'm going to take this shade right here and I'm going to sweep that all over so it buffs it in. So let's just go in with this more intense color first. Right on this highest point of my cheek, kind of right under where my eye ends. It's pretty intense. So I'm going to take this shade now, and I like this because it has a little bit more warmth to it. I can see that it's got some orangey tones in there, which I appreciate. So I'm just gonna kind of buff this area in. Again, going really, and I'm going to take it up here a little bit closer to my nose than normally, because I think what it really does is blends this whole concealed situation in better. As always, I think those blushes are really pretty, and again, they both pull to the warmer side, which is great for someone with warmer skin tones. I've tried some of their cooler tone blushes, are pretty, they just aren't something I pull for. So I'm going to go in with a highlighter now with this pointier side of the brush. It looks really pink in the pan. I think you can see it does have a pink hue to it. Maybe not what I would necessarily go for, but I think it works well with the colors in here. Go in with that bronzer just a little bit on my forehead. Let's go ahead and read about the details. It says, the coveted ambient lighting edit returns for its fifth year, including 100% vegan blush and bronzer in 6 shades, 3 best-selling and 3 exclusive new hues for a glowing complexion. Again, travel friendly, says it's your palette of lighting essentials for anywhere you go. It says it's available this holiday season in limited edition packaging. It's got this like plasticky bit on the bottom, and someone commented that it looks smaller because of that. I think it's just an optical illusion. Features and benefits, everything you need to finish, brighten, contour, and highlight your skin in a single palette, which is kind of what they've been doing ever since they released them. So 3 exclusive shades include the Ambient Lighting Bronzer, Ambient Lighting Blush, and Ambient Strobe Lighting Blush. Formulated with photoluminescent technology to capture, diffuse, and soften surrounding light for skin that appears softer, younger, and lit from within, which is why I love Hourglass products. I think they do these the best out of any of the companies out there. There are other finishing powders that claim the same kinds of things, but I just don't get the same finish I do from the Hourglass products. And of course it says use the double-ended brush, which I used with this because, like I said, it's just easier to get into the pans with a smaller brush like that. You don't need it, but if you have it, it's nice. Formulated without parabens, talcs, fragrance, nanoparticles, gluten. It's vegan friendly and not tested on animals. They are a cruelty-free brand. So what do I have to say about this palette? I think it's nice. I mean, if someone gave this to me for free, I would not give it back to them. I think that they're not my favorite colors though. I really, like I said, I use Radiant Light finishing powder every time, so I don't really use dim light, although I have been using it in these areas here. I think if you are medium to fair, then these shades are really great for you. I'm currently NC35, I was recently color matched again because this is probably lighter than I have historically been because I've been doing so much in terms of trying to address my discoloration on my skin that it just my overall coloring has lightened up as well. And plus all the sunscreen I use, I'm hardly exposed to the sun. So that's probably why. So if you're any deeper than that, this might not be the best palette for you unless you like these blushes. I think the blushes are pretty universal. This one pulled a little bit pink on me. So I like something a little bit more warm when it comes to bronzer. It's a very nice palette. Again, I think it's specific to your coloring though. So if you are any deeper than me, I don't know how much you'll get out of this palette other than these two, and if you like dim light, but this is a little bit more of a cooler tone. If you are like me and you love radiant light and you love radiant bronze light, then this might not be your palette. It does tend to go a little bit cooler, except for up here. These two are very nice. These have warmer tones to them, and I think the blushes are really beautiful. So if you collect them, you'll probably pick it up anyway. If you just wanted to try some Hourglass products, I think this is a good place to start. I have other recommendations for you if you are deeper in skin tone. Yeah, if you're any more tan or warmer, I'll list my recommendations of other items that I use from them that I really like, including highlighters, blushes, and finishing powders. So you can go that route, but it's a nice gift if you have any luxury lovers. Again, no one's going to say, I don't like this palette, but if I was going to create my own palette, it would be different shades than what are offered in here. They're all very good though. They perform like all of the other Hourglass products I've ever tried. They're really nice. Very finely milled. You don't have any sparkliness. Some people feel like there's sparkle, but I've never seen that on my skin in terms of a sparkliness. Yeah, I just don't get that. It's more of like a glow. So that's what I think is a really great thing that Hourglass does, are their powders. So again, get this if you are any more fair than me, if you have more cool tones than me, I think it's a great one. If you just want to try Hourglass products, if you like these blushes, I would go for that. So I hope that helps you a little bit. It's not something that's not my favorite palette that they've ever released. In fact, I'll have to look at my other ones and see, and I'll list for you my favorite one down below, just so you have a reference point for what. I haven't really thought about which one my favorite one is. I know which ones I've used more than others. So I'll go ahead and go back to my other ones and just test them out and make sure, and I will list the ones that I liked the most. If you've also purchased them and you're trying to make a decision on this, although my guess is if you've bought them before, you're just gonna buy this anyway because that's something you've done for the last how many years. So let me know if you like this palette, what you think of it. So I hope that helped you out at least a little bit in making the decision if you wanted to purchase this or not. Again, it's an investment for sure, but Hourglass products are some of the ones that I use up to the very end. So I hope that helps. So if you enjoyed this video, if you learned something, please give it a thumbs up, subscribe, and I'll see you next time. Thanks.